Thank you, Mudoni, for the welcome. Fellow colleagues in community development practice, receive greetings from your Fresh Air Award and your chair here in Kenya. I'll be presenting, then in the Q&A section, and your chair will come in for answers to relevant questions. So in line with Community Development Conference theme 2021, our connectedness and resilience and empowerment, we are pleased to make our presentation under sub-theme number 2, Community Development Practice, Change and Transformation. As Mudoni has highlighted, our topic is on boda-boda motorcycles in Kenya, a source of livelihoods or poverty. So boda-boda is a commercial taxi using motorcycles that is used in East Africa and also commonly in Kenya. So when you look at the history of boda-boda taxis in East Africa and in Kenya, it dates back to the use of bicycles in the cross-border trade between Kenya and Uganda in the early 1960s. After that, it transitioned to use of motorcycles, which are spread to several parts in East Africa. And now boda-boda motorcycles are used to meet mobility needs of people in Africa, especially by businessmen as a means of transporting goods and services to various places, and simply because it's very affordable, easy to maintain as compared to other means of transport, such as the common matatus that are found in Kenya. So this study utilized a review of secondary data on boda-boda transport in Kenya, and it has adopted data from authentic internet sources and journals with the past study in the area. So there are two key main issues that we addressed in this study, that boda-boda as a source of livelihood or as a source of misery. So looking at boda-boda in Kenya, from our findings, we opted to start from demographic characteristics, and we found out that majority of those people who work in this sector are male. So it's a male dominated sector simply because the males are the main breadwinners. And majority of the males that participate in this business are basically youth aged between 20 and 34 years. So you find that it's also a youth dominated area. So looking at that data in the table, you find that those above 8 years are, those above 35 years are about 20%, and below 20 years are less. So the technical team, kindly, I'm not able to view the slides. So we also looked at the business model of boda-boda operations in Kenya, and it was found that it's majorly, we have two models of operation, that's hired operator and owner operator, where basically owner operators are those people who own the boda-bodas. They can either use it by themselves or hire it out. And then we also have hired operators who actually do not own these motorcycles, but they hire them out from the owners and give a fee at the end of the day. As a source of livelihood, we found out that boda-boda offers employment and acts as a source of income to many unemployed youths who would otherwise be idle without the boda-boda. So majority of them in a typical day would go home with between 500 shillings, Kenyan shillings, and 1,000, which translates to about 15,000 and 13,000 per month or more. Looking at this, this is actually above the current gross marginal wage rate that we have in Kenya. That basically makes boda-boda a very lucrative business. So with this, the operators can meet their daily financial needs, and they have that freedom to invest in other businesses. And that has been shown by various studies. So looking at boda-boda as a source of investment, we found out that there are high levels of investment among the operators, And this range from building their own houses, buying livestock, connecting electricity at their homes, being able to pay school fees, and contributing to things like medical insurance cover for themselves, or even buying motorcycles to hire out. So these investments actually provide a wide source of livelihood to the operators and actually provide job opportunities, and therefore causing change and transformation that we are looking at in our today's happening. Besides that, there are those people who operate in spare parts shops or garages, and this also a business opportunity to them. In these areas where we have the garages or the workshops, there are those people with kiosks, and this is also a source of livelihood to them. And so we find that Bodaboda is a source of livelihood to many people in the community, not just the operators alone, but even other members of the community. And therefore, it's a source of transformation and change in the community. So looking at Bodaboda as a source of poverty or misery in Kenya, in as much as it's a source of livelihood for many, Bodaboda also faces a lot of challenges that makes it a source of misery. And according to National Transport Safety Authority in Kenya, the road accident related to Bodaboda are actually on an increasing trend, and we are experiencing road transport injury as per that study. In addition, the Bodaboda operators have also been linked to insecurity. Amongst these challenges, they are hired to kill or snatch handbags from people used by criminals. And even themselves, their lives is also at risk when thieves attack them to steal the motorcycles from them and kill them. And so in this study, we actually conclude that Bodaboda is a source of livelihood for many families and also a source of misery. And in as much as it's a source of livelihood and a source of misery at the same time, it still brings change and transformation. And therefore, it's a sector that needs to be streamlined to improve its efficiency and to be encouraged so that members that get source of livelihood from it can prosper and go on well. Thank you.